Hey, it's your friend Choice CJ here, and we are back with another episode of our Tales of Symphonia Let's Play. Let me go ahead and turn down my headphone volume a little bit, because it is awfully loud in my ears. But regardless, that doesn't have anything to do with what you guys are hearing. Hopefully this audio is pretty well balanced. I've been having some issues trying to figure out the best settings, but I think I've got it dialed in pretty well now. This whole series has been pretty useful for me, just trying to figure out how to deal with audio issues, so that's nice. Chicken or the egg? The designs are half-elves? Yes, it's said that they're almost entirely composed of half-elves. Why'd you bring that up all of a sudden? I was just thinking, they're of the same blood I am. How could they do such terrible things? Ah, that's right, you're an elf. Yeah. Yeah, I know what you mean. When I think about how they're at least half-human, I have to wonder how they can do the things they do. Don't you think it's because they've been persecuted? That's because they treat us like cattle. Which came first, the chicken or the egg? What? Nothing. It's an interesting thought. They're rude to people because people have been rude to them. Yeah, it's definitely a tricky conversation. But anyway, where we last left off, I'm not exactly sure. I think we killed the ranch in the last episode. We took out Kvar, who seems to have been the person responsible for the death of our mother. And so after that, we were trying to figure out what the next course of action was. And now I remember. We have to go into the Tower of Mana. That's why we're standing out front of it. Because we need to go beat the Tower of Mana. The Tower of Mana is the fourth seal. And so, we need to go here for that reason. Also, there is a book by, I guess, some sort of spellcaster named Boltzmann. And we want to get access to that book because it has a couple of spells that we would like to use. Yeah, let's take Kratos. I think that's who we had before. And we have to take Colette. Because she needs to do seal stuff. So we'll leave Sheena, Rain, and Genus behind for the time being. And so this is good for us. Because we have, you know, our main character, Lloyd. We have Kratos, who can provide some melee support and also do some healing. And then we have Colette with all of her sort of the attacks. I'm still not sure how I feel about Colette as like a combatant, because she has a lot of good of these like technical attacks, you know, like the Holy Song and Angel Feathers and things like that. I mean, it seems like she does some good damage, but she's just not like the combo warrior like Lloyd is, which is at least what I like to play in this game. To each their own, though, if anyone likes to control the other characters more than Lloyd, more power to them, but that's just not how I roll. And, you know, I just like Lloyd. Like, I love the way that he's flawed in this game. He's, like, good to, like, good to a fault's kind of a dumb description, but he's, like, sort of, like, seeks justice, like, naively, if that makes sense. Like, he tends to look at things in black and white, which, like, can lead to some difficult situations for him. And he also doesn't do anything halfway. Like, when he wants to, like, when he's, you know, wants to exact vengeance on somebody, he does not go easy. Colette is, you know, an inch. Oh, did you guys see that jump? That was awesome. I haven't seen jumps like that since Michael Jordan. But what I was going to say is, like, Colette is also a character with a lot of flaws. She doesn't like to ask for help from other people. She feels as though she's a burden. So she's constantly apologizing. And all of her issues she keeps to herself. Like, all these sorts of, you know, dealing with losing her humanity issues, she's not shared with anybody until Lloyd kind of, like, pushed her on it. So she, you know, doesn't want to bother anybody, wants to, like, try and be strong and handle things on her own, but it's kind of tough, because I'm not saying that she can't do it, but it's just it would be tough for anybody to do, right? So that's interesting. Okay, so how do I do this? I think we go up here and we do this. Cool, now we got the light. And we have to come in here, move. Sorry, I like to focus on the puzzles. But yeah, so this should do a thing. And it does. Excellent. Easy peasy. I think there's a couple more like this that are a little bit more tricky. But now we can unlock the memory seal, save, and what is this? Lloyd, marvelous! It must be linked to an apparatus somewhere. Lloyd, can you see this side? Wow, this machine is cool! Hey, I can see you too! Lloyd, can you hear me? The door on this side opened. We're going on in as well. Let's meet up and regroup before we release the seal. Okay, gotcha. Cool, and the other reason it was good to do this distribution is because I feel like this configuration has good synergy as well. And so once again, I'm going to control Sheena because she's pretty cool. Boltzmann's book was found. Great, this is what I wanted. Now we can save Pietro. No, it will be difficult for me to use this book with my healing arts. If we had at least some sort of tool to amplify the body's life force... What sort of thing do you need? The legendary horn of the unicorn, or mana leaf herb, the elven medical herb. Both only appear in legends. I'm sure there's a way. Let's take this with us. Yeah! Okay, so that'll be saved for another time. Yeah, now the door's closed, we have to go up our own way. And hey, look, it's another puzzle. So as we are figuring this one out, yeah, here's this. I do want to ask you guys my question of the day. This is going to be a lot less of a sensitive topic than what we had last week. The question is, what is your favorite Pokemon to use in Pokemon League counter format? If you guys are in YouTube leagues or in leagues with your friends, or you just like to watch these leagues and you have a certain Pokemon that you'd like to watch, let me know down in the comments below. For me, it's definitely a hard choice because there's a lot of great Pokemon that are out there that I've used in the past. You know, everything from like Megalopunny in my current UBC squad to Pokemon like Quillfish that I used in my there's Lloyd. Hey Lloyd. that I used in season number 2 of the UBC. We are now obviously in season number 3. If you're not up to speed on my dealings in that league. I also really liked using Entei in Season 2 of UBC, just because it's a Pokemon that's so hard to switch into. Because, like, the Pokemon that can take a burn, or can't get, like, that resists Sacred Fire, don't really want to get burned, necessarily. So it's really tough. Hang on, let me save real quick and see if any of these are mimics, or if those are all good chests. Nope, they're all good chests. Cool. But, yeah, and then I have some good Pokemon on my, I had some good Pokemon on my, PMC team for, season number 2. And for D-League as well. I loved using Embor. Embor is so dang good. It was just amazing, how good it was. I gotta figure out what to do with this guy. Is this right? Yeah, Embor is a Pokemon that comes in and things die. Like, that's as simple as it gets. It's really, really crazy. Yeah, how do we do this? Is this how? I think this is it. No, not quite. And then on my current team, it's really funny. Like, Salamence I love using, and I've used that in the past in other leagues with pretty good success. Electros and Tentacruel have been surprisingly useful for me. I know that sounds goofy. Oh, now I know what I need to do. I need to push it onto this one. and then go to here, and that does it. Okay. Yeah, like, Tentacruel, especially, like, offensive Tentacruel, has been really useful. Just because it's something that a lot of people never expect. So I really like that. And Steelix has been awesome. It's been about, like, as good as I could have hoped for. People just have not found a good way to deal with it yet. Stinger Ring, what is that? Let's see. Is that an item for one of these people? I can give myself a Holy Ring. I guess that sounds nice. Yeah, hang on, let me go look at this. Stinger Ring, no, not in here. Ah, it's for Colette. Okay, great. It's good to know. But yeah, like, I love just finding Pokemon that I want to use and then build a team around them. I'm sure lots of other people do this, but I have, like, multiple teams mocked up that are built around certain Pokemon. And I don't think I'm going to get to draft again before Sun and Moon comes out. And at that time, the teams are going to be completely different because, you know, we're going to have a whole new slew of Pokemon, both from the Alola region and also, like, the Alola forms for the Kanto Pokemon and any new Megas that we might get. So my list is going to grow even further. And the Pokemon that are going to synergize with the new Mons that I want are going to change. Like, can you imagine if there was, like, Counter League before XY? And, you know, you have all these strategies, and then you have Megas that are introduced, and the metagame completely changes. You have, like, a Talonflame being introduced, or what are some other Gen 6 Pokemon that have really affected the way the game is played that are not Megas? Like Greninja, for example. Like, Greninja is just wild, like, at what it could do. I mean, it really didn't get out of control until Oras, of course, but that Pokemon was really cool. And then, Gen 6 also unleashed, the hidden abilities for some new Pokemon, like Superior. Like, that thing was pretty much garbage. And then, all of a sudden, you have to find yourself thinking, wow, like, I have all these strategies that were great before, but now they're kind of suspect. So, I'm really excited about that metagame change, both, like, in Smogon OU, but also in Counter League. It's gonna be really neat. Because you're gonna have Pokemon, like, what else could be some good Pokemon? Like, there's gonna be some really niche Pokemon that are work in Counter League. Like, Mikumiku? Whatever the Sea Cucumber one is. Again, is that the... I don't know. I'm thinking of the Sea Cucumber one, because that's going to be, like, a really good deterrent for, like, some physical attackers. That's not going to work every week, but, you know, it's going to be, like, a cool gimmick. And then, I think that Mikumiku is the, one with the, illusion with, like, the automatic substitute. That one, I don't know if that one's going to be as good, but it still seems cool. Whoa, something appeared again! Can you hear me? We've made it further. It would be best to regroup before we proceed. Okay. Alright. We're making moves. Hey, and they even released a little platform for us, so let's go ahead and save. Okay. Here comes more of them. Yeah, like, I wonder what the meta-defining Pokemon are gonna be. Like, the fact that Salandit, I think is what it's called. The fact that it even exists now is gonna devalue Pokemon such as Heatran and Skarmory. I mean, I still think they're both gonna be OU, but, like, you know, they're gonna be easier to counter. Especially Heatran. Like, I saw a tweet from Pokemon the other day saying he thinks of all the Pokemon in OU that Heatran is the one that, like, hates, that, like, needs its passive recovery the most, like, from leftovers. And so to have that cancelled by a corrosion toxic is really a big deal. Try standing on that pedestal. If it's the same as the entrance, the next path should open. And let's see. Boom shakalaka, there we go. The path is open, the fourth seal. I'm gonna race back real quick just because I want to save, you know, just to save time, because that seems convenient. And yeah, there's no enemies along here, so that's good. But yeah, I think it's gonna be quite a lot of fun. And you know, there are other Pokemon that I'd like to use, like Mudsdale and whatever the Sea of Fish one is. Like, I think they're gonna just be like solid Pokemon in general. Like Mudsdale might be like a Hippowdon Light, if that makes sense. We'll have to see its stats. But anyway, let's talk about this cutscene and then we'll talk more about Pokemon. Whew, man, I'm tired. That's because you're always overexcited in the beginning. It's mana! Powerful mana is coming out! Alright, we need to get Colette in here. What's the best thing to do? Yeah. That seems best. Let's see if we can't, give a couple of orange gels spread out around here.
Do I need...
No, this should be good. I don't need Kratos. Alright, here we go. Fourth seal. This looks dangerous. Alrighty. Oh my, look at that. Okay, so I do real quickly want to throw the magic lens on it so we can figure out what kind of HP it has. And then that'll help as well with Genius and his spell casting. Because now he'll know which spells he needs to cast. And that'll be nice. But this thing so far is quite a pain. Just because of that tail attack is pretty good. And it doesn't seem like he doesn't get staggered all that easily. So we just gotta fill him up with damage and do the best that we can. I'm just gonna be like spamming the same combo over and over. Air thrust. Yeah, I guess that's fair. Oh, look at this combo we got going on. 29 hits, that's pretty cool. I like the way this thing looks, it is pretty neat. I do want to slap myself with one of these melange gels. Okay. And how are we on... Alright, we're a little bit less than halfway done. We're getting there. Usually when they drop to like half health, they start using some different attacks that are definitely harder to deal with. Yeah, like this, he hasn't done this yet. Holy crap. That was not cool. You know, Rain, it'd be really nice if you hit me up with some of those buffs that you're hitting up Genus with. Like, you're giving them that attack upgrade. Yeah, that's not doing anything for him. On the other hand, I could definitely use that. Or I could use a heal. Because I'm about to drop into the low range. Alright, looks like we're doing good. Feeling good. This is going a lot better than the battle with Kavar. That was really bad. I used like 20 apple gels and 20 orange gels. It was really painful. Speaking of orange gels, I need another one. Alright, we're getting there. Alright, we're about 75% done. And I'm gonna need another orange gel. I'll also hit up Colette and Genus with them in a minute. Just because they would probably appreciate that. Now, Genus, use one on yourself. Alright, there we go. We're all set. Just keep going. And then we'll see afterwards if we have any more seals to go to. Oh, I'm glad that we dodged that. That was pretty bad. Or could have been pretty bad if we hadn't been so lucky there. We were also getting low again. Yeah, we are basically out. But we need an apple gel before we do anything. Sweet. Alright, I was trying to block and I didn't even have enough TP to block. But looks like we did it. Alright, so let's see what happens afterwards. We're probably gonna get a visit from Remiel. chosen of regeneration. You've done well in reaching this far. Now offer your prayers at the altar. Yes. O Goddess Martell, great protector and nurturer of the earth, grant me thy strength. Hello? Who's this? Where is Aska? Whoa, it talked! Without Aska, I cannot do anything. I cannot form a pact or a vow. Please, find Aska in order to restore my power. And if you don't remember, Aska is this supposed bird. That we talked about with the zoologists. So, if you hadn't put that together, that's who this person was talking about. So that's very interesting. We'll have to figure out exactly what that meant later on. And now we get our super special cameo from the almighty Remuel. Your journey has been long. You have done well to reach this far. Colette, the chosen one! Thank you, Lord Remuel. Let us grant you our blessing. Thank you. You have taken another step closer to becoming an angel, yet you seem anxious. No. I'm very happy. Now, chosen one, your journey is finally drawing to a close. It is time for you to rejoice. The path to the Tower of Salvation is open. Head to the Tower of Salvation and offer your prayers of regeneration. Then you'll be able to climb the stairway of heaven. The Tower of Salvation. The world regeneration is finally going to take place. Is regeneration really going to happen? I shall do as you instruct, Lord Remuel. I shall await you at the final seal. Colette, my daughter. There, you will become an angel. Like me. The end is finally in sight. Let's head to the Tower of Salvation. Colette, are you sure? Yes, I'm fine. Damn it! Colette learned sacrifice. What does that do? Attack enemies and heal all members in exchange for your life. Whoa, holy crap. It literally means sacrifice. Okay. So, that is the fourth seal. And from the sound of it, it's the final seal. So now we need to get the heck on out of here. See if we can dodge this guy, because I don't feel like dealing with him right now. Nope, we didn't dodge the second one. But yeah, so now we gotta go to the Tower of Salvation. I'm not sure if there's anything in between. But this episode is very young. So we have a lot of time to go make some stuff happen. And then the other thing we'll have to be on the lookout for is what happens to Colette with her angel toxicosis. As Rain called it. Every time she comes out of a seal, she has some sort of sickness. And it's usually associated with a new... loss of humanity. Ooh, that was a nice dodge. You guys see that? That was slick. What's the best way out of here, though? I think the best way out of here is actually the way we came. I just wanted to get to the save. Alright, let's do this. Alright, sweet. We nailed it. Do you guys like that? Okay. Enough nonsense. Let's go down here. We come through this room. There's nothing in this stairwell, so we're looking good. Nope, I lied. That's okay. Fight a couple of specters. But yeah, just to bring a close to the conversation we were having earlier, please let me know what Pokemon you like to use. Or what Pokemon you'd like to use, either that are currently in the Pokedex or are coming out in Sun and Moon. And that'll be a fun discussion. And then, so we were also talking about, before we got into the question of the day, you know, like some of the character flaws with some of these different characters. Lloyd and Colette are both pretty interesting cases. We don't really know a whole lot about, like, Rain and Genus yet. Like, Genus is sort of, like, just, like, a child. And, Rain, you know, for all of her, like, sensibility and knowledge, she gets a little bit, like, overeager about, like, archaeology and things like that. And she also kind of has, like, a bad temper. she's definitely beaten up Lloyd and Genus more than a few times. There's a book titled Spiritua. Would you like to read it? Yes, we didn't get a chance to read this one before. Then I was blinded by light. The priests, Wong and Li, protecting me, disappeared. The Guardian of Light looked very much like the legendary unicorn, but was much larger. I knew I faced my death. Well, that's sort of ominous.
Professor Sage, it's Colette's angel toxicosis.
I see. Let's rest here for today.
What's wrong, Colette?
I would assume she's lost her voice.
What?
Oh, shit.
Everyone, I have something to say.
Huh?
I want to explain to everyone why I was trying to assassinate the Chosen.
All right, we're listening. Tell us about your homeland. A land that doesn't exist in this world.
You knew?
No, but you said it yourself that Silveront will be saved. That must mean you aren't from Silveront.
Yeah. You know, it's really a shame that your intellect's being wasted here. You're right. My homeland is not here. Not in Silveront.
What does that mean?
My world is called Tethiala.
Tethiala? You mean the moon?
Of course not. My world isn't on the moon. Even I really don't understand the specifics. But there's another world that lies entwined with Silveront. As shadow is to light. That's Tethiala. My world.
Two entwined worlds?
The two worlds lie directly adjacent to each other. They just can't see one another. Our scholars say they exist on shifted dimensions. Anyway, the two worlds can't see or touch each other, but they do in fact exist next to and affect each other.
What do you mean, affect each other?
They vie for the supply of mana. When one world weakens, the mana from that world flows to the other. As a result, one world is always flourishing, and the other waning. Sort of like an hourglass.
Wait, so right now Silveront is...
Yeah. Silveront's mana is flowing to Tethiala. Therefore, Silveront is in decline. Without mana, crops won't grow and magic becomes unusable. If there's no mana, the summon spirits that protect the world alongside the goddess Martel can't survive in Silveront either. As a result, the world slips even further down the path of destruction.
Then the Chosen's world regeneration is actually the process of reversing the mana flow?
Exactly. When the Chosen breaks a seal, the mana flow reverses and the summon spirit that governs the seal awakens. I was sent to prevent the world regeneration from happening. I broke through the supposedly impassable dimensional fissure for the sake of protecting Tethiala.
In other words, to assure the decline and destruction of Silveront?
You can say that, but your journey of regeneration is also an attempt to destroy Tethiala. We're both doing the same thing.
It's hard for me to believe all of this.
I'm the proof. I possess summoning arts that have been lost from this world. Please don't look at me like that, Colette. I know that wasn't your intention. I don't know what I should do either. I came here to protect Tethayala, but this world is impoverished and everyone is suffering. But if I allow the world regeneration to occur, then Tethayala will become just like this.
But right now you're helping us, right?
Yes, but that doesn't mean I can just abandon Tethayala. I don't know what to do. Isn't there any other way? A way for Silveront, Tethayala, and Colette to all be happy?
I want to know too!
Have you considered that perhaps nothing that convenient exists in the real world?
The best thing we can do right now is to save Silveront from its current crisis.
What if we don't regenerate the world and just defeat the Desaians?
Although we succeeded in destroying a ranch, we cannot possibly eliminate all the Desaians, and the mana will eventually be exhausted.
Is mana really that important?
I suppose only magic users and scholars worry about it. But mana is even more important to life than water. Without it, the land will die. Mana is the source material which composes everything. At least that's what I've been taught.
Unfortunately, the giant tree of ever-flowing mana in fairy tales doesn't exist in the real world. We live by chipping away at the limited amount of available mana. Why do you think the ancient Magi technology was lost?
Because mana disappeared from the world.
Correct. Magi technology consumes large amounts of mana. If things continue the way they are now, Silveront will eventually lose its mana, just as it lost its Magi technology, and be destroyed.
Colette? R-E-M-I? Ah! You're trying to spell something, right? I'll try asking Remiel if there's a way to save the two worlds.
If it doesn't work out, I may have to kill you after all.
Sheena!
When that time comes, I may fight back because I love Silveront too.
I understand. You intend to become an angel no matter what, don't you?
Wow, so that was a bombshell. To say the least. So what are we gonna do? I guess all we can do right now is find our way to the Tower of Salvation. I don't remember precisely how to get there. Because it's, I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's right there. It's that gray dot underneath the gray blot, if that makes any sense. So I'm not exactly sure how to get there. But I think what we need to do, we can try to go to Luin just to see what's going on there, but I think the right course of action is to go to Haima. And we'll see what happens, you guys will see in a minute why I think that's the right place. But yeah, so there have been like a couple of pieces of foreshadowing about this other world, Tethayala. Both like in hidden and little conversations between characters, in those fairy tales that we read in Asgard and stuff like that. And now everything's sort of being revealed. We're finding out more about the true nature of this place. And there's, you know, just as many questions as answers, like how exactly did Sheena get to Silveront? And, you know, what is Tethayala like right now if it's, you know, supposedly flourishing? One thing I'm really interested in, and I'm not sure that it's ever addressed in the game, is exactly how long these cycles last. Because if Colette's the Chosen and she's like about 16 or 18 or 19 years old or something like that, but other Chosens have failed before her, you know, is the other Chosen about the same age when she died? How many Chosens were there beforehand? Like, has it been like more than 50 years, more than 100 years since the flow of mana has been reversed? That's what I want to know. But again, I'm not sure. I don't remember precisely if those questions ever get answered in this game. All we can do is keep on playing and see what else we learn. Oh, we'll do this. And what I'm really interested to see, you know, so do the angels, like, do the angels know about this? And, you know, and what would they have to say? I guess when we get a chance to go talk to Remuel, we will find out. Because, you know, this doesn't seem like a, doesn't seem like a great system. Because you're never really solving the problem, it's always like a band-aid solution, you know? Oh, speaking of the zoologists, speaking of Aska, there's the little... Darn it, all these enemies, I really need to find that, that obelisk. Oh, and it's so interesting, so Colette, since she doesn't have her voice anymore, she doesn't have any voice in these battles. It's kind of haunting, to be honest. But, shoot, I don't even remember what I was saying and I got distracted by that. Oh yeah, I need to find the obelisk so we can freaking avoid all these enemies. Because there's a lot. But I don't know where it is. It's usually by the, like, the back of each region. But we're at Haima now, so I'm not going to explore much more right now. I'm just going to try and hop on up here. And we'll see what's going on. What did she say? We have to save Pietro. Yeah, you're right, we promised. We've got Boltzmann's healing technique, but it alone isn't enough. Let's see if we can go talk to him. Let's get a save off. Let's go into here. Is this where Pietro is? Nope, just a bunch of randos. What about on the upper floor? Let's go check that out. Yes. Everyone! The healing technique! We found it, but... It was there, but I can't learn it yet. I'm not experienced enough. I promise I'll learn how to use it. Please wait just a little longer. I understand. Please, save him. Does he mumble anything? No, we can't even talk to him. Please help Pietro. Yes. Yes, we will. But there's a lot that we can't do yet. So let's see if... The thing that I want to check out is if we go all the way up to the top here. And if this doesn't work, I do have an idea on what we need to do next, but... No, okay. I thought this would trigger a cutscene, but it's not supposed to happen for a little while longer, I suppose. We can go to the zoo, guys. And that might be a good idea, actually. It might trigger a cutscene talking about the unicorn, because they're saying that we need to find the unicorn horn, or something like that, in order to get enough, like, power. In order to cast this healing spell. So these guys might know about a unicorn. So let's give that a shot. It's the best, best lead I have at the moment. Hello, Nova. Hmm, what is it? No. So all he has is information about Aska, which we don't need right now. So let's keep looking. We can try and cross to the other continent, but that's not really going to do anything for us. As you can see, the Tower of Salvation is on this side. Let's just try and take this guy out, and then we'll see what happens. Oh, cool, he's got his, powered up water spell, so that's good. Let's try and take these guys out. But yeah, I have a feeling that the rest of the episode here is just gonna be trying to figure out exactly what's going on. Which is fine. I like exploring. And it's kind of fun just to talk about, like, the stories and how they involve the characters and stuff like that. Like, if Colette really knew about all of this, like, would she have accepted the Oracle? It's hard to say. because, you know, she doesn't want the people of Silveron to suffer, but she doesn't want to cause suffering to anybody else either. She's, like, such a compassionate person. You know, and in a way, that's a character flaw as well. Like, because she's so compassionate, she doesn't want to bring a burden onto anybody. She doesn't want anybody to feel pain. Oh, we can do the skit. I'm starting to wonder more and more about this. About what? Whether or not this world regeneration is really right or not. Was it that much of a shock that the Chosen lost her voice? You! Don't you ever feel anything? The Chosen becomes an angel and regenerates the world. Her current condition is a test. Remiel said that as well. Then why, if they're both angels, are they so different from each other like this? One would assume that it's because she is not completely an angel. If she becomes a complete angel, will she return to normal? Who knows? You! Taking out your frustrations on me won't help anything. Well then, would you have her stop the journey of regeneration and sacrifice all life in Silveront? I know we can't do that. But I want to save her. Yeah, that's exactly what I was just saying. Like, if everybody really understood about sacrificing another world, about Colette losing everything that makes her human, you know, it's a very complicated thing. You know, and as cumbersome as these skits are, it's really cool because it, like, really helps to demonstrate the inner turmoil that these characters are having with these ideas. That's not a thing, is it? No. I'm really trying to dodge these enemies because I'm kind of sick of fighting them. Is it around the corner here? Is this the obelisk? Please. Please be. I see it! It's behind there! I see it! We can travel around here a lot more quickly and then we can spend less time being lost. Yeah, next I'm going to try to go to Luin and see if that helps us figure out what to do next. Because... yeah, I don't have any ideas at the moment. My main idea was to go to Haima and see if we could, you know, because we could see the Tower of Salvation from there before. I thought that would trigger some sort of cutscene, but I was wrong. Maybe we need to be able to heal Pietro first? But yeah, as you can see, there it is. I needed this so bad. No! Not another one! Not again! Alright, let's take out these ogres. Colette's tripping over herself again. But yeah, if we can get this, then we should be able to navigate a little bit more easily, and it gives us a better shot of finishing up by the end of the episode. Like, getting to a point of resolution. Oh, we're poisoned, that's not good. I think we can tough it out and make it to the end of the battle, as long as somebody is there to spam a heal. Oh, yeah, we did get healed from our poison, so that's nice. Thanks, Rain. You actually did something good. I'm gonna give Rain a hard time. Like, all she's doing back there is spamming heals, which is what I want her to do. Oh, this is nice. Okay. I was just warming up. Alright, give me this. Yes. Alright, now we should be able to run around in just, you know, a matter of a minute or two. And we'll see where it takes us. Let's do the skit too. Sigh. What's up, Colette? What? Genus is tired? Sorry. Last night I spent a long time thinking and didn't sleep much. Ah, okay. Then let's go ahead and take a break soon. Thanks, Colette. Yeah, even when she's like suffering so badly, she just wants other people to be well and to be happy and everything. And it's like she's like so like perfect that it's annoying. to an extent. But it's okay. The thing that really gets me like curious is that, you know, she's dealing with all of these changes and stuff like that. And like, at what point is she gonna start being cynical like everybody else? That's like the sort of development that I'm really excited for. It's kind of like in Final Fantasy X, the development of Yuna. As she learns more about about being a summoner and everything like that, really changes her a lot. But, you know, but so she was strong before in that she doesn't want to trouble anybody, but then she becomes strong in her defiance against the traditions. So we'll have to see if that turns out to occur here. Because, you know, there's going to have to be, like, a realization that the status quo is not okay. Because it just never ends. Alright, so here we are at Luin. Let's see if we can find anything. If this doesn't work, then I do have another idea. Doesn't seem like anybody is here whatsoever. Just a completely destroyed and ruined town. Alright, the next thing I'm going to try is to go to the lake. Because we've talked to a couple people at the Houses of Salvation that would indicate that the unicorns tend to like this lake. So let's see. And if that doesn't do it for us, then I'm really lost. I might just call it an episode until we figure out what happens next. Look at that! Okay, this was the right place. It's a unicorn! Rain, it's a unicorn! Yes, but why is it? Wow, so there are still unicorns left on this side. I wonder if we can make contact with it. The unicorn horn? Yes, in order to use Master Boltzmann's healing technique, we need the unicorn horn. But how can we get over there? Can we just swim to it? You won't be able to hold your breath that long. Damn it, isn't there anything we can do? There is a way. What? We could summon Undine, who exists somewhere in this world, to control the water's mana. Undine, you mean the summon spirit? We don't have anyone who can summon the summon spirits. I haven't formed a pact yet, but if I can form the pact, then I can summon. Now that you mention it, you did say you could use some summoning techniques. Are you a summoner? I'm a guardian user, but I can summon too. I'd heard that art of summoning was lost a very long time ago. Well, it still exists. Anyway, if you're not interested, I'm not going to force you. No, we need the unicorn horn. Please, do it, Sheena. Alright then, let's go to the Seal of Water. Undine should be at the seal. The Thoda Geyser, right? Let's go! That means we get to go into the bathtubs again. This is quite a detour. Yes. This is true. Let's do the skit, and then we can make our way to Thoda Geyser. A summon spirit. I wonder how the pact works. I can't wait to see it. There he goes again. Won't you get bored halfway through? Shut up. I'm interested, so I'm excited, okay? It's fine that you're interested. But the problem is the way you get bored with everything. Shut up. Stop ganging up on me. Stop telling us to shut up. We're talking about your attitude. Shut up, all of you. That's what I mean. Rain's got a temper. But it works, though, because nobody messes with her when she speaks up. Alright, so we gotta go all the way down to Thoda Geyser, which means we've gotta go over the pass. Hakonasia, I think is how it's said. I'm not sure, but it's whatever's right here. And we nimbly dodged all of those guys. Alright, so here's the peak. We can come back down. Things are looking smooth. Things are looking great. And let's hop back on Noish and keep on heading south. We gotta go down quite a ways. But we're almost there. But yeah, it's interesting now that we have to kind of circle back and get the summon spirit. I wonder if we can talk to the summon spirit. I don't exactly remember how that goes. We ran right into an enemy. That's okay. Okay, well, probably what I'll do is I will get right outside the seal, and then we will call it an episode. Also, what I probably ought to do is find an inn and like try and heal up and get high on my TP again, because everyone's looking a little bit low. Luckily, I don't need to stock up on too many items, so that's good. Oh, you know what I did want to do? I wanted to give some new items to people, because I found them in the place. I realize that that's not very specific, but anyway. Alright, so she doesn't need a thing. Let's give her a mood robe. I think that'll do it for her. She already has a stinger ring equipped, so that's good. Lunar Guard actually is a pretty nice upgrade. Give her... she already has a thing by stun. So that's fine. Dual Star. Wow, that's a... well, it's a big upgrade for attack, but we don't really care about Genus' attack all that much, if you ask me. Cleric's Hat's nice. And what about Kratos? Yeah, let's give him that. And that should do it. Okay. If you guys hear any sirens in the back, I apologize. There's some ambulances driving by. The place where I live, like, we're right kind of on a major road, so we get all sorts of crazy traffic. We get ambulances all the time. Well, let's do the skit. Kratos. What? Have I grown stronger? Your sword skills have certainly improved. However, you have realized that that alone is not enough, have you not? That's why you felt compelled to ask. What strength you seek, what path you seek, no one but you know the answers. Yeah, I guess you're right. However, there undoubtedly still remain even more fighting techniques that you do not know. Continue to fight alongside your comrades and defeat your enemies. You may find your answers along that path. Alright, I'll trust that one day I will find those answers. In the meantime, I will start with what I can do now. Wow, that didn't sound like me at all! Alright, we got mastering. I actually don't know quite what that is. But I think we can go in here and take a little nap. Yeah, let's head on up. This is not a bad time to rest. It's 100 gold a night. Yeah, that's a no-brainer. The other angels can talk. Why is it just Colette that wound up like this? I don't know. What do you mean you don't know? You're always talking like you know everything. Don't you even know of a way to save Colette? It may be that the Chosen's role is to save the world in exchange for giving up her humanity. What? How can you talk like that? How can you be so cold? Just what is it that you want me to do? Rain. It's not that I care about Colette any less than you do. But if she doesn't become an angel, the world will be destroyed. What about you? Didn't you come here to kill Colette in order to save Tethiala? I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry. It seems I got a little excited. So, it's painful for you, too. The one suffering the most is Colette herself. Yeah, isn't that the truth? And that's what I've been talking about all episodes. She just shoulders the burden by herself and doesn't let anybody help. But we can go talk to this person now, get a ride to the geyser, and we should be looking good. He's not so excited about the washtubs. You'd think that the Chosen could travel around in a slightly more dignified manner. But yeah, now that we are out here, this is where I'm going to end the episode. It's been a very crazy one, lots of information. Things have been definitely being revealed. And it makes for a very good plot. It's just like, you know, you have these two conflicting forces, there's a reason to want to support both sides. So anyway, that's going to do it for me. Make sure you sub to the channel so you can keep up to date with the series, and that way you can also stay up to date on all of my latest Pokemon and gaming content. And until the next time, I will see you guys later.